Hi, this is Brad Linder with Liliputing, and today I wanted to do a short review of the Acer Aspire One 521. This is a 10.1-inch netbook, but instead of shipping with the usual Intel Atom processor, it actually comes with an AMD Athlon 2K125 Neo processor. I know that's sort of a mouthful, but the long and short of it is that this machine has a AMD single core processor, a low power AMD processor, and ATI Radeon HD 4225 graphics. And in general, that gives it much more performance, higher performance than you would get from most Intel Atom processors and integrated graphics. Battery life's not necessarily quite as good as you would expect from a machine with an Atom processor, but that's the trade-off that you're going to make with this sort of machine. And battery life is better than I've seen on previous AMD low-power chips. So first, let's take a quick look at the physical design. I'm not sure how well this is coming across in the video, but you've got sort of a textured design. I mean, it's not even textured. It's more like a sort of checkered pattern here. Goes up in a triangle here. Pretty attractive. I like it. This is a brown lid. I think it comes in a couple of different colors, though. But this is the demo unit that Acer sent me to review. The Aspire One logo is sort of put in to the little bit so you can feel it with your fingers. The Acer logo up there on the top. Around the sides, you'll see that you've got microphone, headphone, two USB ports, power, lock, Ethernet. Nothing on the front except for a couple of status LEDs. VGA, one more USB port, so this is a total of three USB ports. HDMI output, which is something you don't see on a lot of netbooks these days, and card slot for SD card, XD, a couple of other formats. On the bottom, there is a single access panel, which you can remove to get at the wireless. The RAM is somewhere in that vicinity. Hard drive is over here. Seven screws to undo, and once you pop it off, you can access all of those internal components. And the battery is down here. It's a 6L 4400 milliamp hour, 48 watt hour battery. And it fits pretty much perfectly in the back of the unit. So unlike some netbooks that have higher capacity batteries, you would see it sort of jut out from the bottom or from the back. And it sort of comes out a little bit in the back here, but it fits in very nicely with the design of the laptop. So aesthetically, I'm pretty happy with that. Opening it up, you can see it's got a very glossy lid, or glossy screen. Colors are pretty good, though. I'm pretty happy with it. You're not necessarily going to want to use this outdoors or in bright sunlight, where that lid is sort of going to turn into a screen, even with the power on. But for the most part, it's pretty good. And one really nice thing here is that the screen opens up almost to a 180 degree angle. So that's something you don't see on a lot of netbooks. Honestly, I don't see much use for this, but I know that some people really like to have that. I don't know if they want to use it to read ebooks or do other activities, but you know, that is sort of a distinguishing feature here. The keyboard and touchpad, pretty good. The keyboard takes up almost all of the space. It's not quite 100% the size that you would get on a larger laptop, but that's what happens when you have a machine with a 10.1-inch display. The only way to really get a 100% full-size keyboard is to have an enormous screen bezel or something else. The one area that I'm not a huge fan of, and this seems to be the case on most of the Acer netbooks I've used recently, is down here you've got six buttons that are almost crammed into the space, just barely bigger than one shift button. Seems like you probably could have had better use of space here, but you've got your page up, page down, and four arrow keys all in that one little spot down there. And it takes a little getting used to. I still tend to have to look down at the keyboard when I want to hit one of those buttons. These also serve as the home and volume up, volume down, and brightness adjust buttons when you hold the function key on the other side. Overall, though, I'm pretty happy with the keyboard. At first, I was a little bit worried that there doesn't seem to be much space between the keys, so it's kind of hard to feel which key you're on with your fingertips, but I was able to, using a online typing test, get about 103 words a minute. I can't type much faster than that on any keyboard, so overall, pretty comfortable keyboard, pretty easy to use. Touchpad, likewise, pretty easy to use. I like the fact that they made room for two distinct buttons. You can feel the edges with your finger, so you're not going to go over the side. Could be a little bit wider, probably, but, you know, the only way to make it any taller would have been to get rid of those two distinct buttons. So I'm pretty happy with the overall width, width and size here. And it does support multi-touch gestures, like two-finger scrolling. Let's go ahead and turn it on for a second. And let's load up a web browser, and you can see it's pretty responsive. I've noticed that most netbooks, because they come with Intel Atom processors which support hyper-threading, they're pretty responsive. They don't have problems running. Most web browsers, you can have 6, 7, 8 tabs open. It's not really going to slow down. You can listen to music in the background. But where this really seems to excel is CPU and GPU intensive tasks. So for example, I'm going to go over to YouTube here and type in 720p HD and just see what comes up here. So here's a video that we can test at high definition. I'm going to put the mute on. That's actually not in high definition. Okay, so now we're watching it in high definition. And it's pretty smooth. You know, maybe there's a drop frame here or there, but overall it's pretty smooth. I've noticed that 1080p videos from YouTube are a little bit choppier, but overall significantly better than anything that you would expect from a netbook that doesn't have this kind of graphics. So let's go all the way up to 1080p here. And you can see when you've got a lot of motion, it's a little bit jerky, but it's playing. Now, the truth of the matter is you're probably not going to have to play 1080p flash video very often on a netbook that only has a 1024 by 600 pixels display. 1080p local video plays perfectly, and I think that's really what matters more, is if you happen to have a bunch of 1080p videos on your hard drive for your larger, more powerful computer, you can copy them over to your netbook and watch them without having to transcode them or convert them or do anything. They'll play pretty smoothly. And as you can see here, even flash video is playing pretty well. I ran some benchmarks, video game performance, and while it's not going to play bleeding edge video games super well, it can handle a couple of older video games pretty nicely, and it's more than twice as fast as a number of other machines that I've tested on CPU tests. So for example, I took a large folder filled with files and I zipped it, and it did it 2 to 3 times faster than a typical Intel Atom processor based netbook. It wasn't quite as fast as something like the Asus UL20A, which is a larger machine with an Intel CULV processor, but it was pretty close, actually. And because of the ATI HD, Radeon HD 4225 graphics, it was actually twice as fast as that Asus netbook at video game benchmarks. So for example, I ran the Street Fighter 4 benchmark. While neither computer is really up to the task of handling that game with all of the graphics elements set to high, the Acer netbook here was able to score about twice as high on the graphics benchmarks as the Asus netbook. And if you set some of the settings to lower, you could actually get 30 frames per second even on the Acer netbook. You can check out my review at Liliputing.com to find out more details about those benchmarks and see some charts and other information. But overall, I just wanted to give you a quick overview of this netbook, show you what it looks like, show you what it can do, and that's pretty much it. It sells for about $349, and that's there are definitely some netbooks that would sell for a little bit less, but it's probably the most powerful machine that you would find that comes with a 10-inch display, only weighs about 2.8 pounds, and gets around 4 hours of battery life, I would say, and it can do high-definition video, it can do some gaming. It's something that really stands apart from the netbook crowd. It's a little bit different from things that we've seen. Even though it looks almost exactly like a number of other models from Acer, with the similar case design, similar keyboard, similar touchpad. So, There you go. That's the Acer Aspire One 521. This is Brad Linder with Liliputing.com.